Welcome friends to the session which is going to deal with global indicators and how the global indicators affect the flight routes and the travel by flight. My name is Amruta Haldankar and I'm a trainer in aviation, tourism and hospitality. Now suppose if we are talking about airfares between two particular cities, what are the factors that they get affected with? So one would be the class, the other would be the type of carrier that I have taken, the nautical mile differences between both of the cities. It also gets affected whether I'm catching a flight on a weekend or whether I'm catching a flight on a weekday. It also will get affect whether it is a high season or a peak season. All of this and the most important factor that a fare might be dependent on is the route that I'm taking. For example, if I'm catching a flight from Mumbai and going to New York via a Pacific Ocean, so what it means is that is if I'm taking a halt at around Hong Kong then and arriving at New York, then there will be a different fare. Whereas if I take a flight from Mumbai and go across London and to New York, that will be a different fare. So it all depends upon what kind of routes I am going to taking. Now this particular route, when we are talking about an air flight, are indicated by global indicators, which we are going to talk as GIs. So when we are talking about global indicators, the global indicators over here will be changing by the types of stops that I'm taking, where exactly this particular stops are there, from which area am I going to which particular IATA area and which IATA sub area is involved in the crossing. It might also depend upon which of the oceans were crossed by. So all of these factors come together and give us a global indicator or a GI of a particular flight route. So as soon as we know the GI, we can easily go ahead by checking different rules depending upon which GI have we taken for that particular route. So in all total we have 10 global indicators or 10 GIs. Each of them have different combinations. So in order to see into this more details, this particular session will involve ITA areas, sub areas, city codes and airport codes. So before going ahead with this session, make sure that you are prepared with your city codes, ITA areas, the countries belonging to each of the sub areas, to understand this session better. Now let us check what are these global indicators that we are talking about. Now let us see what are these 10 global indicators. Now what you have over here is roughly how the world looks. We have TC1, that's Traffic Conference Area 1, ITA Area 1, TC2, Traffic Conference Area 2, ITA Area 2, and TC3, that's Traffic Conference Area 3, ITA Area 3. Alright, we might have Atlantic Ocean position over here and Pacific Oceans on this side. Now suppose if I'm talking about a particular flight which is just roaming around in Traffic Conference Area 1, that is it is not leaving Area 1. So Area 1 we have North America, Central America and Caribbean areas and the South America part. So what will happen here is that the air flight route will be considered to be Western Hemisphere, and so this is a WH, which indicates that that particular global indicator is WH, that is Western Hemisphere. Now the next one that we have over here is Traffic Conference Area 2. So we have Traffic Conference Area 2 which deals into Europe, Middle East and Africa. So if the flight is roaming around only in Traffic Conference Area 2, we are talking about the global indicator of that flight being EH, which stands for Eastern Hemisphere roughly, and so the GI would be EH. Now if we come over here, TC3, the flight is not leaving Area 3 or Traffic Conference Area 3, which has the Asian and Southwest Pacific. So that's SEE, that's Southeast Asia, SASC, that's South Asian Subcontinent, JAPCOR, that's Japan and Korea, and Southwest Pacific. So we have the flight which is not leaving Traffic Conference Area 3, then again its GI or the global indicator would be EH. Now what is happening over here again, if I am changing the area, suppose if the flight is moving between Area 1 and Area 2, obviously it is crossing over the Atlantic, that is it is transatlantic flight. So obviously we are telling it to be or saying that it is indicated by global indicator AT, which stands for roughly transatlantic or over Atlantic or crossing over the Atlantic. We have one more case over here which is Pacific, which I will be telling you later on. So there is one indicator which might be possible is PA, which is across the Pacific, wherein I'm talking about a flight which moves across TC2 and TC1 but via the Pacific. Now we have another global indicators on top of it, which are there, which may involve TC1, TC2 and TC3. So what is happening over here is the flight is roaming around in Area 1, Area 2 and Area 3. And in that case, it is also crossing the Atlantic. So there are two GIs or two global indicators possible. So that's Atlantic and SA, which roughly might stand for South Atlantic Zone. So if the flight is moving across North Atlantic, then we would be considering it as AT and SA for South Atlantic. So that is TC1, TC2 and TC3. Now, if the flight is moving between TC1, that's Traffic Conference Area 1, and Traffic Conference Area 3, that is if I'm talking about American side and Asian side, but the flight route is taking across the Pacific, that is via the Pacific. So we have two global indicators, which are PA and PN. All right, so there are two global indicators over here, which are PA and PN. Both of them will be crossing over Pacific across between TC1 and TC3. Now, what we have is TC2 and TC3. So suppose if we are talking about TC2, which is Europe, Middle East and Africa, and we are talking about TC3, which is Asia and Southwest Pacific zone, we may have either AP or RU or TS or FE or EH. So these are the global indicators which are possible, that is the routes that the flight can take if the flight is traveling between TC2 and TC3. So if you check, there are 10 different GIs and some of the GRs are twice coming into the picture. So it all depends upon how the flight is crossing over, whether it is a transatlantic or a Pacific across the flight, and when and how it is changing the areas. So in order to understand this very clearly, we are going to take each GI individually and see what are the conditions for particular GIs.